Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. Joe here. Kyle's right over there. We finished driving for 2 days, finally made it. We're up north into the Temagami region. We're going to do 8 nights, 9 days, backcountry camping, canoeing, portaging, fishing, loving life.
You got it, man.
It's 5 o'clock now. We've come to the first campsite along our paddle so far, and we're gonna take it. We wanna do some fishing tonight. We haven't slept more than an hour in like 48 hours.
Pretty much.
So this is home.
We got everything all squared away. I've got my tent set up. My food's rehydrating. So I'm going to go and attempt to catch a fishy or two. What a novel idea. It's nice out. It's almost 6 now, probably around 6. Starving, but beauty weather. It's awesome out here. I'm liking the boat. My first time paddling this pack boat. It's like a canoe kayak hybrid. The open top kayak, 26 pounds, Kevlar Fusion, made by Swift Canoe and Kayak. I picked mine up in Gravenhurst at their store there. They got a few stores around Ontario. This is a 13.6 Adirondack model, meaning it's 13 feet 6 inches long. Loving it. First failed fishing attempt of the trip. I was out there for maybe 45 minutes, an hour. Get a bite. The wind's picking up and it's pushing me. I'm paddling against the wind to get back to camp now. I'm hungry, man. I'm just gonna stop and eat and relax. I think that's it for me for tonight. No more fishing, no more canoeing. I need to get some food into me and I need to get some sleep. So I'll check back in with you back at camp.
Looking good. Gonna be pasta tonight for dinner, boys and girls.
How do you feel now after supper?
Better. Some chocolate and Sailor Jerry, though.
Well,
late enough.
7:15. I don't expect to be awake till past 9.
Nope, not at all.
It's our first drink of the trip. Cheers, there, bud.
Cheers. That's quite terrible. What happened to the half the bottle there, Joe?
This is like 200 mils. That was not a shot. Map man.
We parked here, right here at the end of this road. Beauty Road, Gamble Road, whatever you want to call it. Here's the Evelyn River. Came down just a little bit, like one click, down to this little first campsite, which is okay. Tomorrow we have a whole bunch of probably 3 kilometers or so before we hit first portage. Just like back to back to back to back to back, little tiny ones. Getting to McPherson. And I'm thinking maybe we come down here, hit these few other portages, sleep down here by Dry Lake or Catherine Lake. That's my thoughts.
Not thoughts. Yours. Those are my thoughts, not yours.
Where do we start today on the map? Can you even point that out?
What is a map?
Exactly. Couldn't find a toothpick in a forest.
No, nope, it's a sand dune in a desert.
Well, toothpick in a forest works too.
Hey.
What?
I can see your breath. Ugh, I can smell your breath. What are you doing?
I'm gonna pack that ring in a bed. What are you doing?
Samesies.
Samesies.
Well, day one in the books.
What?
I just did the same to him. It's like not even 9:30 and we're both in bed. It just got dark.
As level as the Leaning Tower of Pisa.
We waited for it to get just dark enough to go to bed where we didn't feel too bad about it. Tomorrow's another day. Tomorrow's our first real full day. We're all looking forward to tomorrow. Tomorrow. Good night.
Ten hours of sleep.
What?
I feel rested, rejuvenated, and ready to do this.
Oh, beauty morning.
You can probably hear the tail end of that motorboat that just went by. Last night we only got in a few clicks. Didn't have to do any portages yet, so we are gonna see some motorboats, maybe even up till tomorrow. But we're trying to get deep, we're trying to get super far interior so that stops. Just packing up my gear, Kyle's already fishing. He said he doesn't wanna do cooked breakfasts. He said he doesn't wanna do cooked breakfasts because he wants to be able to eat on the boat while he's catching fish. So he's gotta have any kind of little advantage to beat me in the fishing, you know? So I'll let him have it.
He heard me.
We're starting our journey. 2 days on the Lady Evelyn River. And then we are going into some lakes, interior lakes. And then we'll be ending our journey on the Lady Evelyn River as well. So this is a very slow moving river at this point. It's very wide. There is a current we can feel, but nice and easy paddling, man. Beauty weather. It's a boat coming up behind me, I can hear. So that's not the greatest, but hopefully within a couple days we'll be out of that nonsense.
Well, that was a first for me. Kyle and I were paddling up to this little river, this little rapids. I heard like a arf, 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 grunting. I thought there was a bear or a moose, so I was telling Kyle to be quiet. Turns out it was an otter. They're pretty big animals, man. He came right out of the water, swam by us. Very cool.
We're on the start of our first actual portage, and we're portaging because there are some rapids.
That was a rough portage, man. It was only 300 meters, but that was rough. It's not marked, it's not maintained very well either, so we're bouncing off stuff, trees are down. Crazy, crazy. Dose of reality, to be honest.
Well, that's what we portaged around. Right behind me, you can see all sorts of rapids. This is the slower, lower end of them. So they got a lot more fierce up that way. I think I'm gonna try and fish in these rapids though. I want some trout in my belly.
Kyle just saw a brookie. He spit his lure and came back up to the surface for his lure. So that's a good sign. I haven't got anything, but that's par for the course. I'm using a little MEP spinner with a split shot about a foot and a half above it. I'm getting no action at all. Kyle might have been making stuff up too. He does that. I'll do a couple more casts here, I think, and head on down. There is another waterfall up right up here, maybe in about an hour or so. So hopefully we can try to
fish the rapids, fish the waterfall. Ooh, had a little scare there. Okay, check back in. Look at this beauty. Black spruce, huge rock formations. This guy over here. Can't be all good.
There's some little fiddleheads growing right next to these rapids. Well, Kyle's back there trying to fix his backpack. I wanted to come down and check out the portage before we do it. It's pretty rocky, man. It's right next to the water, and there's blow down trees and everything. Crazy.
That was a rough portage, man. 490 meters, which is nothing, but we're not walking on any kind of trails that I've ever really done before. Killarney, when I was in Killarney Park, the trails, some of them were pretty rough. But it seems like every trail, every portage trail in Temagami or Lady Evelyn Smoothwater is pretty rough. The black flies are starting to come out. They're not biting yet, which is awesome. I'm thankful, but they're swarming, so it can't be long, another day or two. We got to make our way to one more 50 meter portage, nice small portage, and there's a campsite at the end of it. It's 12 o'clock now, so we're gonna go do that and then have some lunch. Kyle's trying his hand at some fishing. I'm not too positive.
Okay, Joe.
All right, let the bragging rights begin.
Yeah, you know, nice little brook trout.
Beautiful, man. Very nice.
Very nice. Cut the head off, right? Right behind the gills.
You can if you want to. You don't really need to.
Well, no fishies for Joe. Kyle ate his trout. We've got to do a portage, and then we're on the water for a little bit, and then there's another portage. And then another portage. There you have it, folks. This is our portage trail. A little rocky. These portages are something else, man. I know I've said it already, but it is true. Black flies are starting to really come out, but they're still not biting, which is fantastic. So, I hope my camera doesn't tip. I'm using my DSLR right now in the canoe. It's on a tripod, and it's just kind of precarious, so I'm just trying to really be careful. Kyle, I can see, getting out of his canoe, starting the next portage. So there's one place to put out, and it's there. And Kyle decided to leave his canoe there and go into his portage. That's really helpful, real nice of him. All right, so you can see we're at the put in at the end of the portage. See Kyle behind me, he's about to put in. And that water is a bit quick. We completed our portages for today. We're gonna camp on this section. We're both pretty beat, but it's a beautiful view. There's huge rocks everywhere, jack pine, black spruce. So we'll do some fishing tonight, set up camp, eat some supper, have some camp life. Things are so much better when you're on the water here. These portages, man. Kyle and I were doing like a 1,000 meters, a kilometer portage, single carry. Last time in Algonquin by ourselves, we'd take a turn with the canoe in the pack. No problem. They weren't flat by any means, but they weren't this. So, yeah, it's an eye opener. It's an awakener. So day two has been hard, but rewarding as well. Except for that damn trout.
This will be just fine, eh? So Kyle went up there to scope out the campsite and...
It worked just fine, eh?
Oh, it's a touch windy, bud.
Having gravel tonight. That's the ground beef, rice, and veggies. Called gravel because the ground beef never really rehydrates back properly and it feels like you're eating gravel.
By far my least favorite meal that I've dehydrated, but it's a good staple. The rice and the ground beef and the veggies, it's good to eat. So the Frank's Red Hot will be welcomed on that. So the bugs are getting pretty bad and I'm gonna apply some bug spray. I've only used bug spray once today so far. I watched a video in preparation for this by a guy named Winter Trucker. Winter Trucker has a ton of experience in the north. He's in northern Ontario. And he was showing how he applies bug spray and how he can get away without using a head net in black fly season, which is awesome to know. And what he said, yeah, I'm filming here, bud. Oh, way to go. Good job. He got my bear bag, my bear hanging bag up, stuck up in the tree. So yelling at me for not doing it properly yesterday and dummy over here friggin' gets it stuck first try.
I'll get it.
You're gonna get it? It's 50 feet in the air, man. Anyways, so he applies like I'm doing now. He's spraying it on his hand, rubbing it into his skin. And this one has 30% DEET in it. The one he was using had about 25, I believe. This is Ben's. He was using Deep Woods Off. I think the main thing is that we're not using the aerosol. It's just the pump spray. It works a little bit better. And then you're rubbing it right into your skin, man. You got to soak up that DEET. Love that DEET. Right up into your hairline. So, and then I'm going to go wash my hand. Thanks, Winter Trucker.
Run out of rocks here.
High.
What are you trying to do, Kyle?
Well, if I can hit the bag, it went up and it spun itself around.
Uh-huh.
And yeah.
Yep.
It's stuck. There's no good
I'm going to climb that and get that.
Are you sure?
Yes, 100%.
Okay, if you die.
No, I will not die because I'm not you.
Okay.
Well, everything's done at camp. Food is eaten, food is hung. Firewood is collected and processed. Water is procuring. We put the drops in it already. And it's 7 o'clock. So it's time to catch some fishies and try our luck at some fishing. It's a nice night. There's no wind at all. Bugs are pretty bad, but not as bad as they could be. Yep, Kyle caught two walleye. Small ones, but still, I can't get a bite, man. I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Doing everything the same as Kyle, except for I don't have braided line on. I have mono on. I have a second spool that I'm supposed to put braided on. I just wanted to get out here and fish, so I can't see that being the difference. But Kyle's cast 100 times too, just like me, and he's only got the two. So it's kind of weird. It's kind of finicky. It's not as hot fishing as I thought it was going to be. And I am kind of bummed out, if I'm being honest. I want to catch a fish, man. I don't care if it's a pike at this point. Like, I'm not getting any bites. It's frustrating. Got a little perch. It's all right. I'll take it. It's better than nothing. But we're going to let this guy go because he's not eating size. I don't even know if perch are in season, to be honest with you. I got a fishy! Calling it quits for fishing tonight. It's almost 9 o'clock. Been out here almost 2 hours, so I only caught that one little perch I showed you guys. Kyle caught a couple perch. Well, he told me that they were walleye, but after I caught the perch, he said that they looked just like that. So I'm guessing they're walleye as well. We can look at his video and see. I'll go back, have some drinks, help make a fire, and warm up. My legs and everything are all stiff from sitting in this boat for all day, and then again for another couple hours tonight. So lake is glass. So I guess this is a tributary of the river. They named it McPherson Lake because it kind of widens out pretty good and doesn't have a lot of current at this spot. So can you hear the peepers? Gorgeous place, guys. Really, really nice here. Do you hear all that? It's spring peepers, birds. It's probably it, but it's loud. This camera is adjusting the light, so it looks a lot lighter than it is, actually. It's 10 after 9, so getting dark. It'd be probably dark around 9:30, I imagine. The sun's gone down. We can see the purples and the pinks in the sky right now, so that's kind of cool. Enjoying some 40 Creek copper pot by the fire. Today was an interesting day. It was an eye-opener. It's a good day, good end to the day too, so that's good. I'm excited for tomorrow and what that's gonna bring. There's no hardwoods here at all. We're burning balsam fir, spruce, cedar, eastern white cedar. No birch actually here either.
No, not this,
spot. We came across a bunch of birch before, but it's pretty northern feel. It has a northern feel to it anyway. Yep. Balsam fir sucks, man, trying to split that stuff. There's burning rounds right now.
Kind of.
Kind of. Yeah.
This is our gorgeous sunset. We got a perfect view of it. Kyle is doing very inappropriate things behind the camera right now. Gotta ruin her, bud.
Day 2 is in the books.
He's getting back for yesterday. Day two is in the books. I'm a little chilly. I'm stripping down tonight. No sweater on tonight in the sleeping bag to try and minimize the condensation. Up and at him again tomorrow. Looking forward to it. Good night, folks. Sold up face. Foggy lens. Morning of day three, boys and girls.
Kyle said there's a bunch of steam off the lake, so let's go check that out.
Fish just jumped right there.
Gonna get some breakfast in us and head on.
Almost all packed up. Just got a few little odds and ends I gotta put in my bag. Kyle's gone, eating breakfast in his canoe, trying to slay them fishies. So I'll catch up with you on the GoPro in the canoe.
This pack boat is taking some getting used to. I like it a lot. Paddling like this is a little different. I've only ever kayaked once before. It's very similar to that. It's a kayak paddle. It's light. It's a light boat. It's a good boat. I'm happy with it. You can tell it's going to be a hot one today. 8 in the morning. I've already got a shed layers. I do things a bit different in this canoe. Instead of taking my jacket off around my arms, just right over the top of my head, nice and easy. No messing around. Life jacket goes right back on. Oh, and all is well. We're going to try to bypass a portage. Kyle has got it on the map where we might be able to go to the right of this island up here and paddle down a little streamy kind of river instead of portaging 170 meters. And I'd much rather do that. So that's what we're gonna try out. Let's see if it pans out or not. Might be able to.
I don't know.
Yeah?
No bridge is coming up here.
Nope, no go. Too many trees blocking the way, and it's like 6 feet deep of water, so there's no chance of getting out and pulling it over. I tried to run over the log, it wouldn't work, so. Don't want to ding up our boats or put a hole in them on the third day of a 9-day trip. Well, just taking a little snack break, eating a granola bar in the boat. Kyle's over there fishing. Just got done a portage, pretty easy portage, relatively. So, you have a 700 meter portage coming up. I'm hoping that's a normal kind of portage, but beautiful day. Black flies are just starting to come out for the day. They're not biting yet. They only started biting last night, like around 5. They're swarming all day, weren't biting, started biting around 5. So I assume today and forward they're going to be biting, but it's not really that big a deal. I've dealt with a lot worse black flies than this, so. We'll see in 2 days if I feel the same way. This area is gorgeous, man. All this rock. Just beauty. We gotta be careful. There's all these rapids and they kind of suck you down. So you gotta watch it. Give a wide distance. So we're over here, heading that way to our portage.
Ooh, hello. Can you see me? Okay, so, a little ETA. We got a little turned around. We were trying to find a 700 meter portage, and we found it, but the portage dead-ended. And there was no, it literally dead ended. There was nowhere to go.
So we hiked through the bush for quite some time, and I found a second trail. I followed that trail and went out to the water on it, and it came out to a second portage. So we took that one, and it, on the books, it was supposed to be the 340 one, but I think it actually is the 700. Kyle, his boat's there. We've resorted to double carrying for a little bit. It's a little treacherous here. I don't know if you can pick it up in the... I don't know if you can pick it up in the GoPro, but I'm walking on top of trees and big boulders here. Ah! So, anyways, good times. Kyle's a little pissy. He's not happy the way his canoe is riding on top of his backpack, and I agree with that. It's backpack's a bit too tall, and smashing the canoe down into our spines and into my vertebrae near my neck there, but that's okay. It's all just getting used to it. I gotta bring a smaller pack next time, not as much gear. I put too much gear this time, thinking because I have the small boat, it's okay. It's not. So I'll be using the 70 liter pack from now on instead of this 115 from Doug. Here we are at the end of the portage, and it is windy.
First trout I've ever caught in my life. She's a beaut. Nice brookie, and we're gonna eat that guy up. I am so jazzed right now. Look at that, compared to my hand. It's like probably three times the size of yours, I think, Kyle.
Well, that was bittersweet. Caught this awesome brook trout. I'm super happy with it. Good size. Beautiful fish. We're gonna eat him. Lost my fishing rod. And the commotion, I guess, of me getting this fish in the boat and bleeding everywhere, me trying to get him to settle down, me trying to film, me being excited, I must have knocked my fishing rod over the side of the boat. My mom bought me my fishing pole for my birthday a few days ago, for this trip specifically, and I bought a brand new reel. And I'm really bummed out that, not for the fact that I don't have a rod anymore, but for the fact that it was a birthday present from my mom, and I caught my first brook trout on it, and all this stuff. It was a good rod too, and real. So I feel a little bummed out, but what are you gonna do? It's a lesson to really take my time and think about things and try to keep my head even when I'm excited. So anyways, paddling on. We're gonna keep this fish. I'm gonna try and portage with him and cook him for supper over a fire. We've come across some class one, maybe class two rapids. I'm gonna run them. Kyle's spotting on the shore. We've already scouted it out. Got all my stuff in my dry bag. Let's do this. A rush. Awesome. I'm pumped. Well, it's 3:30. We're along the side of the river right here, not at a campsite at all, but we're starving, and I've portaged and carried this fish all day long. He's starting to get stiff, so we're gonna cook him up. So for this shore lunch, we're just using the Bush Buddy and a bunch of butter. All you need is a few twigs. And this trout's so nice, it's not gonna take long to cook up. Oh, it's about done. I think this piece is done. First piece, done. Moment of truth. Wow, not too shabby. I'm gonna eat the skin and everything. Oh man. She's a beauty. So I'm splitting it with Kyle. Because it was such a big fish, you know? There's so much to go around.
You done yet?
Okay, after this, we have to find a campsite because we're both just done. And it's really, really hot. And I need to relax, so. We'll move on soon. You like?
Very good, man.
Well, that was delicious. It hit the spot. Time to go find a campsite. This is home day 3. Super buggy, but let me show you what's on that side of the camera. Man, these bugs are relentless. Before I start setting my tent up and getting my gear all together and everything, I gotta get some water. So I have a full liter of water I collected down at the water, obviously, and I'm doing drops this time. These are pristine drops. It says 5 drops per capful. I do 6 just to be safe. Got 6 a part A, 6 a part B, excuse me, and then we let it sit for 5 minutes till it looks like yellow Gatorade in here. Pour it in this, do a little swish around, shake it, and wait for half an hour. Then it's good to go. This is a nice level piece of ground, so I'm happy to camp here. No rocks. Perfect. This is how we're portaging. We have the PFDs attached to the outside of the pack. Easy access. This bag is hungry. My pole for the big Agnes, it's all one piece. Nice and convenient. It's got this 3 spreader trifecta dealy here. Yeah, that's definitely not how to say that, but it's got a spot where it branches into 3, a connector. And that's basically it right there. So I just got my tent set up, as you saw. Everything's good there. My fly is still wet from condensation from last night. It takes honestly 10 seconds in the sun to dry it. So I'm gonna leave my tent just like that, air it out with the bug screen done up. And I'll go lay this on the rock in the sun, along with my sleeping bag that had wetness from condensation. Thank you.
Now that that's done, black flies.
It's 10 to 8. I want to go fishing. Kyle's feeling a little beat right now, and I understand it. I felt that way earlier. So he's nice enough to bring an extra fishing pole and reel and let me use that. So thank you, Kyle. I am appreciative of that. I would love to be able to still fish on this fishing trip three days in. So yeah, I'm gonna go walk out to the water. It's quite a walk, but I wanna do it, and I'm gonna catch a fish. Make it all worth it. A redemption trout.
Beauty out here.
Well, hello, Mr. Camera. Fancy seeing you on this rock in the middle of the river. Mine. That's it, I'm calling it. It's gonna get dark soon. So out here for probably half an hour, 45 minutes. No bites at all, but that's okay. Some solitude is nice. Nice scenery, and I was able to get some cool shots. So it's all a win. Tomorrow's another day. We've been in this lake, or in this river system the whole time. So we gotta be coming up into some lakes soon, and I imagine with the lakes will come the pike. It'd be cool to switch over. We've been trying to catch trout this whole time. Kyle's at one, I'm at one. Trout, that is. He caught a bunch of perch, but once we get into the pike, that'll be a whole different ball game. Be using spoons and big spinners and stuff. So I caught that big trout on a Meps Aglia number 2. That was a gold colored one. And now that lure is gone with my fishing rod, so that kind of sucks, but oh well. Gonna head back now, sit by the fire, have some drinks, relax, probably turn in around 10 or 11, get up and do it again in the morning. Day 4 tomorrow, already. Seems like it's flying by. Have you seen my friends? The black flies. I like this camera. Doug let me borrow this Olympus camera. It's a stylus, I believe. Somewhere? Stylus. Olympus stylus. Ooh, look at that guy.
I gotta drink something, man. Yeah. Only way to cope with these freaking bugs.
We're gonna get drunk so we don't care about the bugs anymore. Kyle's overheating, so he's got his sexy shirt off.
Oh my god, it's so warm.
And yeah, man, these bugs are relentless. Like, just non-stop, just non-stop. But they're not even as bad as I've seen them before. I've seen them where they're biting all the time. Like, they're biting now. I've got welts. I'm starting to get all swolled up. But that didn't start till, actually, last night as well. Each night, I think, they get bad like that. But hopefully when the sun goes down completely, they're going to be gone.
Look at your camera.
What?
It's like being destroyed with bugs.
Oh, with bugs, yeah, for sure. Like, somehow they're getting in my, they're trapped in my net, I think. Oh my goodness. What kind of silly concoction you got going on?
We have a Walmart brand raspberry lemonade drink with vodka tonight.
Oh, actually, that's not that bad sounding.
It doesn't.
When you mix the whiskey and the Sailor Jerry with the raspberry. Ah, he's in my. Oh, I'm blue on this thing. Oh well.
What does that mean? That's
what that means.
Oh.
Blue on that. Look at the GoPro.
Blue man group.
So, you got a part in the blue screen. This Olympus doesn't have the best low light functions. Kyle and I were just discussing how this is the best campsite. I think the best campsite I've ever been at, to be honest with you.
Best view.
Best view?
This is the best view, by far.
We have and like...
We have like, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, we have 5 waterfalls.
Five substantial...
Yeah, there's one that's like a 30-foot drop, like...
5 substantial waterfalls right in front of us. Black flies to no end.
Oh.
That's a huge plus.
We got wet wood.
Wet wood?
We're rocking, man.
But we got a fire.
Kind of.
We have to sit about 4 or 5 feet away from it because we're so hot. It's 9:22 at night. We're sitting here no shirts. The black flies have subsided for the most part. They're still buzzing around, but they are not half as bad as they were. So that's a good plus. Kyle just snorted one up his nose.
It was
legit. I swear to God, he just did.
I've eaten like 6 of them. Why can't I snort them? Oh my God.
Oh. I ate a couple today, but Kyle's taking it to a new high and snorting them. You got a buzz off that? Oh, you know, he's rejecting it. He's snot rocketing it out.
Oh, so messed up.
Oh my goodness.
Why do we do this?
This is, without a doubt, the most intensive canoe trip I've ever done.
You know why this is the...
Can't put that in a video now.
Look at this is what it does in low light. It's not so bad, I guess.
I have a lot of hiccups.
Hold on, I gotta hit the... Are we recording? Are we recording? How do you feel after today? Okay, that's that.
That was good.
Look at that moth. So many moths.
Day 3 in the books. Day 3 was a hard day. A lot of realizations came. There's black flies in my tent at night, so that's awesome. First ever caught a trout. First ever lost a fishing rod in the lake. Good day all around. Tomorrow's gonna be another hardcore day. I imagine it'll be pretty hot as well. So, sunscreen, breaks, and lots of water will be the name of the game. I'm headed to bed. I'm in bed right now, sleep in my tent. So, you guys have a good night, and I'll see you in the morning. Good morning. Morning of day 4. Feels like day 4. 6:30 in the morning. I haven't heard Kyle get up yet, but I can't hear anything over the sound of this waterfall, so who knows. Black flies love moving water, so this is a breeding ground, this campsite. It's a picturesque campsite, beautiful here, but lots of black flies. So we're into the lakes today, and so a change of scenery, and I'm looking forward to it. Maybe some pike on the line, too. Time to get up, face the day.
We just did this portage called Fat Man's Portage, right over Fat Man's Falls. It was intense. The portage itself was rocky and hard and difficult, but the entrance was, or the exit to get into the water, was like a cliff, man. I had to line my boat down and everything. It's too much to film these portages. They're brutal. I'll try to do it more, but man, it's like, I feel like I need a film crew out here. I'm doing this stuff and try to get shots. It's so much work. So anyways, my friends, the bugs are back. Old black flies. Kyle says he thinks he smells so bad that they don't care about him. Probably. Keep getting pretty hot, so keep dumping my. I can't even talk. I'm losing my mind. Keep dumping my hat in the water to keep me cool. This section of the river is pretty cool. We've ran two sets of small rapids now. We had to line one, and we're going through a third one right now. Not too bad. Definitely not anything past class one, even if that. But it's nice. It's nice to have a little moving water and little obstacles to avoid. Oh, that was a lot less than I expected. Threw it already. Oh, Kyle's complaining that it's nice looking.
Well, my camera's always
away. Oh, wow. Oh my goodness. This almost looks like out west. Wow. Beauty, man. Well, we're on a over 2,000 meter portage right now. I feel like crap. I think I have sunstroke or heat exhaustion or something combined with bug bites, because I have not felt this way in a long time. When the water touches me, like when I'm paddling and I get dripped on, it's like this horrible achy pain feeling. I'm exhausted. I can't even muster up any energy, so I think I'm doing this portage right now, which is difficult already for me. So I want to get to camp. It's 1:20. I want to get to camp and I want to sleep, because I cannot keep feeling like this. This is pretty rough. Not gonna lie. Well, something's wrong with me. It's heat stroke, sun stroke. Heat exhaustion. I don't know what it is, to be honest with you, but it might be part to do with some bug bites I got. My legs got destroyed last night. It's been a rough day. I almost couldn't make that 2,000 meter portage. Kyle went back and probably carried my canoe like 800 meters or something like that, man. So I've never felt so bad. This is rough. Let me show you my bites. This one's really bad. It's like oozing. There's pop. There's pus all the time on it. Yeah. Needless to say, this sucks. And I feel bad that I had to, that Kyle went back and got my canoe. I told him not to, but he saw how bad I was looking. I feel a little bit better now. Take some Benadryl, eat some food, drink some water. I don't want to lay in the shade for the rest of the day. It's like 5:30 or something. I don't have an appetite, but I'm going to force something down. I really hope this goes away. I hope I can sleep it off. Excuse me. Because this is only day 4, and we're here for 9 days.
Good. I don't know how or why. It was a thousand times better. Last night, I was like, I think what I did today is I kept hit the food and I hit the water a lot harder than what I just did before.
Yeah, I'm gonna step up the water game.
It made a huge difference today.
Feeling a lot better now. We're out in the boats, trying our hand at some fishing. It's almost 8. I ate some supper, I slept. We went and cut some wood, but it killed me after I was all up, and right before we came out here to fish, we went and cut some wood, and it drained me like crazy, but I don't feel half as bad as I did today. I'm praying for an overcast day tomorrow, and this is the first clouds right now that we've seen in 3 days. The first day was raining, the next 3 days, including today, we're on full sun. So now we're in the lake, and there's opportunity to catch walleye, pike, and lake trout, I believe. I got nothing.
Yeah, nothing, man. I think I got one solid bite and then nothing.
It's pretty shallow for most of it.
Yeah, it is. Like, you're out like 20 feet, you look down, it's like 4 feet deep.
I was fishing in the middle there. I was jigging and everything. I switched a jig, meps, a spoon, a rapala.
Yep. That's pretty much everything I did too.
I feel like crap now. It's 9 o'clock, I'm in bed. I feel like I'm getting sick, like a cold or something like that. I'm achy, I'm cold. I felt better after we pulled in here, ate something and all that nonsense, but I'm starting to feel sick again, and a lot worse. I'm not happy.